friends, my name is Gayatri Bajpayee and today's video on copper cement material model. Suppose we are doing any static analysis. For that, what material properties are required as an input? That is, Young's modulus of elasticity, density and Poisson ratio. But if you are doing the analysis for dynamic condition, dynamic state, at that time, what material properties are required for FE simulation? So that condition, there are lots of material models are available. As in the previous video, I have explained about Johnson-Cook material model, which gives the coupled effect of strain, strain rate and temperature. Similarly, this copper cement material model is also available, in which it gives the coupled effect of strain and strain rate. In this video, we will learn about this copper cement material model, their parameters and how to find these parameters by using the stress strain graph. So okay, let's start to learn. This is called copper cement material model. First bracket shows strain effect, second bracket shows strain rate effect. This complete is called flow stress and these brackets are called dynamic yield stress. Okay, so one by one we will see what are these parameters. So this is flow stress and this is dynamic yield stress and this is the product of tangential modulus and effective plastic strain. So what is the dynamic yield stress? That is equals to, this is sigma naught, which is static yield stress. Sigma y is dynamic yield stress and sigma naught is static yield stress. And beta is what? Beta is hardening coefficient. And it is tangential modulus. This is initial tangential modulus, which is also called as Young's modulus of elasticity. So, and this is subtraction of Young's modulus of elasticity and tangential modulus. And this is effective plastic strain. This is strain rate and these two are the parameter of strain rate affected parameter. Strain rate dependent parameter C and P, strain rate and effective plastic strain. So this is the initial tangential modulus, which is also called like Young's modulus. If we see the graph between stress and strain, so this is the graph like this. So whatever the slope of this, that is Young's modulus of elasticity, or we can say initial tangential modulus. And what is the slope of this graph after the yielding? After the yielding, when plasticity will come, that time whatever the slope of this graph, that is called tangential modulus at yield static stress. Okay, so that is tangential modulus. This is ET and this is E. Okay, as we have discussed about the copper cement parameters, if we are doing an experiment by using LS Dyna analysis software, okay, and we are doing some experiments, this is one example in which they are doing the rigid sphere impact of plate at high speed. So what material properties are required as an input? So if you are using this matte plastic kinematic material model, this kinematic shows the high strain rate. So what parameters are required as an input? So this is the elastic modulus, static yield stress, Poisson's ratio, tangential modulus, and these two are strain rate affected copper cement factors. So okay, so these this is one screenshot in which they have given these material properties. So this is the density, rho, elastic modulus, Poisson ratio, and Young's modulus of elasticity, tangential modulus, and this is a failure plastic strain, and this copper cement strain rate parameters, this C and P values. So this is one screenshot on how to give this parameter. Here we can see they have not asked about the tangential modulus and also the beta value. As we have seen in the previous slide, that beta value, beta is the hardening coefficient. So what is this beta value? In which parameters this is depends when we have to give or not? And as we know, tangential modulus and Young's modulus, failure plastic strain, this is static yield stress, that we know how can we find. This is static yield stress we can find through the quasi static process by using UTM machine. We can find at very low strain rate the stress and strain value. So at that stress and strain graph, what is the yield stress of that material? So that is the static condition of yield stress of material. So okay, but what is the beta value? So that we will see in a brief. So what is the hardening coefficient? That is beta. So this is basically depends upon the kinematic hardening and isotropic hardening. If kinematic hardening is there, then we are taking beta is equals to 0. If isotropic hardening is there, then we are taking beta equals to 1. in lots of paper they have just skipped this beta term itself, and in some paper they have taken 0.2, 0.3 like that, this value. So it depends on your requirement, what is your application. So accordingly we are taking the beta value. So isotropic hardening is called when yield surface increase in size but remain the same shape. We are having lots of failure theories. So suppose you are having the failure theory, 1 Mises failure theory or distortion energy failure theory is there. So what is the yield surface? What is the safe yield zone? So we are taking the yield zone is like, if you are taking maximum shear stress theory, then that is different. If you are taking a distortion energy theory, so it is different. So suppose this is the yield surface. So okay, this is the center of that yield surface. So what is showing, if you are taking any stress value, this is the stress value. So if you are taking any stress value under this surface, so it will be safe, that we are telling about this failure theory. So if it is up to which limit, it is up to elastic limit. If you are going up to elastic limit, okay. So after that, if you are going up to plastic limit, then what will happen? So in isotropic hardening, it is saying it will increase like this. I mean the center of this surface is same, only size will increase. The yield surface size will increase, but shape will be same. This type of the shape and center of this yield surface is same. So suppose here to here you go up to elastic limit, and after that it is plastic limit. From here this is A, this is B, and this is C. So this is A and this is B and this is C, like that. Beyond that, if you are going, so like that, this is called the isotropic hardening. For that condition we are taking beta equals to 1. But if you are taking kinematic hardening, it says yield surface translate from its original position. So this condition is occur when suppose you are taking one this type of a specimen and you are doing one tensile test on that. So due to this tension, some compressive stress is generated as a reaction. So this type of compressive stresses are generated due to this tension force. Okay. So if you unload it, still there are some compressive stress inside that specimen. Then again if you start to compress it, I mean again you start to load it, and this specimen is already having some compressive stresses. So due to this compressive stresses and this loading compressive stresses, it will start to go in their plastic region very soon. So if we make the graph like this, so it will be elastic region and then plastic region. Okay, then we start to unload it like this, and then again compressive loading up to this unloading, then start to loading in the compressive, because it is already having some compressive stress. So again we start to load in compressive side, then it will go in plastic form very soon. So this, whatever this value, this value, it will not match with this value. Okay, so the tensile stress is more in compressive stress. So as we can see in the yield surface form, so suppose the yield surface is like this. This is the yield surface up to elastic region, but when you go for the plastic region, so it will shift like this. It means center of your yield surface will shift. This sigma C, and this is up to here, this is sigma T. So here we can see sigma T is more than sigma C, equal. Here if you see, the sigma C and sigma T are equal, but in a plastic region also sigma C and sigma T are equal. But here it is shifted. So how much it is shifted, that is called alpha, that is called Bossinger effect. So this is given, this thing is given by the Bossinger. So that's why it is called the Bossinger effect. Now I just want to tell you about where this type of the hardening are required, because here we can see if cyclic type of loading is there, then this beta values are required. If it is not cyclic type, then this beta value is not required. I just want to give a brief introduction about the hardening model. So where that beta value required, what exactly the hardening model is. Actually, this is not directly related to the copper cement model, but this last term is related because the beta value is depend on isotropic and kinematic and all value. So for that, just simply I want to explain about what different types of hardening models. So what does it mean? So perfectly elastic model is means what? Simply like this. Okay. If it is saying idly rigid plastic material model is there, then it means simply like this. This is stress, this is strain, this is stress, this is strain. So this is like this. And then elastic perfectly plastic model is there, suppose. So what, how it look? So this is strain, this is stress, so it will be like this and this. This is called elastic perfectly plastic model. Now it is coming hardening material model under monotonic load. Monotonic load means only single loading, I mean no cyclic load is there. So that type rigid linear hardening model. Rigid linear hardening model is means what? Suppose this is stress and this is strain, so this will be looks like this. Elastic linear hardening model, elastic linear hardening model will be like this. This is stress, this is strain, and then Ludwig power law, so it will be like this. This is some curve will be there. This is stress and this is strain. So this equation is like sigma value equals to y plus h times e the power of some k or something like this. So this is your y, I mean whatever the static yield stress is there, like that. And after that, what is the power? That is in strain. Hardening model under the cyclic loading. So that model is required isotropic, kinematic and mixed hardening. So isotropic is there, that we know beta will be, we will take 0. If kinematic, then beta we will take 1. If mixed, so both type of hardening, then beta value will be 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like this. In the some paper I have seen, they have taken the beta value like this. So it is required to know what is your application. If it is cyclic loading, like some turning machine is there, some cutting force you have to find. So this is cyclic type of loading is there, then definitely beta value is required. But if sudden impact is there, monotonic loading is there, then this beta value is not required. So you can simply skip that term. Okay, then we have learned about copper cement material model, their parameters, and what is the significance of their parameters. What is hardening coefficient and when it is required. Now we have to determine these parameters. Most of the parameters we know how to determine by using quasi-static process and dynamic processes. So if you are having the dynamic yield stress by their corresponding strain rate, then how can we determine their parameters, that copper cement parameter, by using excessive. That we will learn in the next video. And thank you very much for watching my video. If you are having any doubt, please ask me through the comment box. I will be very happy to give the answer. As I have seen in previous video, you have asked lots of questions and I tried my best. So thank you very much once again.